Okay, our next exercise is going to be exercise 66, the squeeze bottle. That can be found on page 208 in your Rhino Level 1 manual. And it asks us to start with a small object's inches template. So let's go into Rhino and start our new drawing, small object's inches. And the next part of it then asks that we create some layers. Now to do this, I'm going to go to the edit, pull down layers, edit layers. I could create new layers, but in this case, all I'm really going to do is rename. So I'm going to rename the default layer as curve. I'm going to rename layer 1 as construction. And I'm going to rename layer 2 as bottle. There are a number of other layers that are listed in the manual on page 208, but we're not going to use those because we're going to stop at the point where they begin to create the cap. All I'd like you to do is create the bottle itself, and then at the end I'll talk about adding the decal materials, a spotlight, etc. So that's all set with our layers. Let's move on to page 209. And we'll begin to create the rectangle. So I'm going to close my layers there. I'm done with that for now. I want to make sure that I'm working from the curves layer. So make sure you have the curve layer active. And I'm going to start in the front viewport using the rectangle command right here. And the first curve in the front viewport is going to be 4 by 7 1/4. So I'm going to come out, I guess if you want to say 8 boxes, which is 2 inches, to the left of the origin in the front viewport, click and then begin to drag up. So this box again, the length is 4, hit enter. The width is 7.25, hit enter. And it will create that rectangle. I'm going to move to the right viewport, and in this view, this rectangle is 2 by 7 1/4. So again, I'll use rectangle. This time I'm going to come out 1 set of blocks, or 1 inch. And again, this is 2 enter by 7.25, enter. You can see in my perspective view what I have now. Next step, step 2 on page 209, is to lock these two rectangles. So I'll go to edit and then visibility and lock. You know they're locked because they're now grayed out. Alright, I'm going to zoom in a little bit here on the bottom of these two rectangles. Step 3 has me use the ellipse command from center and pick the intersection of those two rectangles. I'm going to drag out to the last grid intersection before the outside of the rectangle. Do the same thing on the other axis. You can see where I'm at, the last intersection before the outside of that rectangle. So here's my ellipse. Step 5 asks that I move that ellipse up. So I'm going to use the front viewport. I'll use the move command under transform, move, and make sure you use your shift key. So I'll click right here at the intersection of the midpoint. I'm going to move up using my shift key, one row of, one grid space, or 0.25, or 1/4 inch. Step 6 then asks that I create a circle on the top. I'm going to come up here and create a circle. And I'm going to use a top view because I want to make sure that these end up the same size. So I'll come out to this last grid again. So I've got an ellipse on the bottom and a circle on the top. Now move on to page 210. Alright, back to my front view. I'm going to use my front view, and I'm going to maximize the front view this time. And I'm going to continue to use the curve layer to create the profile or the shape of the outside of the bottle in the front view. Again, I'll use curve, freeform, control points. I'll start right at the edge of that circle on top, and I'll begin to create the shape of this bottle. You'll notice that snap is on, so it's creating that shape. Although when I get to the bottom, I feel like I need another point down here on in between these two grid snaps. I'm going to turn snap off. I might control Z back a little bit just so I can make sure that I get a little bit of a flat surface and then come back up to the endpoint. Once I have that curve, I will use my mirror under transform once again. Pick the midpoint, hold down the shift key, and mirror that to the other side. Now I need a similar curve in my right view. So again, curve, freeform, control points. And if you want to use snap at the top here, you may do that once again. Although you're not going to get much of a curve with that snap just because you only have one row of dots. I think I'm going to turn that snap back off just because I'd rather be able to get more of a gradual curve coming down. And I know I'm not going to use it at the bottom as well. In this case, maybe turn snap back on so that I can get right to that corner there where my ellipse is. So there's that. And again, I'll use the mirror tool. So mirror that to the other side. And if we look at our perspective view, you can see I've got those four curves on each side of the bottle. Next on page 210 is to create the lofted surface. So I'm going to change to my bottle layer. And next I will use the loft command. Really important step here. Surface, loft. And when we pick these curves, we need to pick in the clockwise direction. So if I zoom in here on this bottle, I'm going to start with this curve up here and then work my way around in a clockwise direction. Be careful that you do this, otherwise that loft is not going to work. I'll hit enter, and in this case I want to leave the style as normal, but I want to set it to closed loft. So make sure you choose closed loft. Click OK. And I have a bottle shape now using that loft command, kind of an indented bottom. And I'll move on to page 211. Okay. Page 211, it wants me to cap this. We've done this before. I'm going to go to solid, cap, planar holes, and I'll select the bottle and hit enter. And that places a cap on both the top and the bottom surface where I didn't have any lines when this loft was created. So So that's all for page 211. Let's move on to 212. We're going to flatten out the sides. So I want to change back to my curve layer. And in the front viewport, I'm going to draw three lines. You can see there on page 212, it shows me what these lines are supposed to look like. So I will use the line command, and I want to start above the top of the bottle, and then I want to extend down below the bottom of the bottle. So there's one line. Repeat that again, but this time down the middle. Again, start above and finish below. Repeat that on the right side, starting above, finishing below. So I've got those three lines. Now, in the right view, I need to move these lines a little bit so that they are intersecting the side of the bottle. I'm going to maximize the right view so I can see this, get a better sense. Actually, I need to be able to pick the lines in the perspective view. I'll start with this center one, look back to the right view. I'm going to hold down my shift key, and I'm going to drag this out. And I can tell you right now, I need to turn the snap off for this, so that I can get this just a little bit of an intersection. You can see that I've just come inside the outside of that bottle just a little bit. Let's go back and look at the other two. I want to grab each side now. Hold down the shift key to select both of them. Maximize the right view. Hold down the shift key to lock ortho on and drag these in a little bit on the outside of your bottle. Make sure that you get outside of the top circle up here. You don't want to cut off the hole on the top, so make sure you get on the outside. I know there's not much of a gap there, but it should give us what we want, a little bit of a flattened surface on the outside of this. Okay, now I'm ready to use the loft command once again. So I will go to surface and loft, select those three lines, kind of hard to see. So there are three lines, and we want to uncheck close loft this time. So don't use close loft on this one, and we'll click OK. And just to make sure, I'm gonna go to shaded. Yeah, there you go. So you can see what I'm gonna end up slicing out. That little bit of the bottle is gonna be removed. Probably not quite as much as they're showing there in the manual, but it's going to be enough for me. And then I'm going to use my mirror once again in the top view. I'll go to transform, mirror, and I want to pick somewhere in the center along that center axis. Hold down the shift key again to lock that and mirror that to the other side. And then on to page 213. This is where I'm gonna use my difference command. Now, it points out the DIR, and so we might need to check the direction of each of these surfaces. So I'll type in DIR, select that, hit enter, and I want it to go to the inside. So as long as it's going to the inside, it's all set. That one's good. Let's try this one. Again, that's going to the inside, so that's good. Hit enter to finish that. And now let's do our difference. So I'll select the bottle, solid difference, and then I will choose each of the two curved planes or surfaces and hit enter. And there you can see I've got a little bit of a flattened edge to it. So that's where we're going to stop with the bottle. The exercise does continue on to include a top. I don't want you to worry about the top. But what I would like you to do is to add a decal to the surface of this bottle. See if you can add a decal out here. Add a material, obviously, to the bottle itself. Create a ground plane. Do the usual setup. Add some lights. Render this. And again, save it as a JPEG to submit to course sites. So this concludes exercise 66, which is the squeeze bottle.